I would say that if somebody's diagnosed with a terminal illness and, you know, like the prognosis is, like, they are palliative, right? There's a lot of, you can call it cultural myths, you can call it stigma, it's guilt. On the client's piece, I'll talk about the caregiver's piece, right? If you put your client or your loved one into a residential hospice, it's a lot of guilt. It's a lot of embarrassment that I am not able to take care of my loved one, right? Again, it's a pressure from the society as well. And if you talk from the client's perspective, sometimes the client, what can you say? They don't want to leave home. They want to die at home, right? They don't want to go into residential hospice. If the caregivers are have to put them into a residential hospice, the client is sad. You know what I mean? They think that their loved ones, you know, are not able to take care of them. And again, if it's a community-based hospice like we are, Hard House Hospice, and we send our volunteers and our counselors in homes, right? Some of the families may be reluctant to have an outside help. Again, there are a lot of factors, but again, every family is unique. Every family has different family dynamics as well. Every person has a different thought, a different approach, you can say, right? So it depends. You know, it depends on the education and awareness of that family as well.